Hey guys, if you've updated to the new Premiere Pro CC 2017 11.1 Spring Update, you'll probably notice that titles are different. We now have a new Essential Graphics panel. Now, the titler tool still exists, it's just now legacy. You'll notice that there's no title option from the new item menu in the project panel. You can still, however, hit Command or Control T to make a new title, but because the point of this tutorial is on the new Essential Graphics panel, let's go ahead and explore this new feature. So to get started, go up to Window and select Essential Graphics Panel. Now, Premiere Pro has a bunch of pre-made built-in templates you can work from captions and subtitles, all the way to video game templates that are made in After Effects. That's right, you can export motion graphics templates from After Effects, and you can fully customize them here in Premiere Pro's Essential Graphics panel. This includes updates to the color, the font, the size, all of that. This will replace the live text template workflow, but previously made live text templates will still work. Also, here you can choose from the list view or the thumbnail view. I prefer the thumbnail view as you can use a zoom slider to increase the size of the thumbnail to preview the graphics in the panel. If you want to choose from one of the templates, first create a new sequence in your project panel. Then choose a template from the Essential Graphics panel and drag and drop it into the sequence. It will then take a second to load the motion graphics template. So click on the title template in the sequence, and then you'll notice that it'll change to the Edit tab of the Essential Graphics panel. Once you click on either of these layers, the text or the shape layer, you will see that further editing capability is then expanded. But if you try and edit the text here by double-clicking, nothing will happen. Now, this is the part that I struggled with at first because it was quite confusing. Why can't you edit the text? This was the way that live text templates work, so doesn't it make sense to just double click here and edit? Unfortunately, no. So it turns out that if you want to update the text, you need to go and select this new text icon in the toolbar. You will notice that when you click on it, that you get the option for a standard type tool or a vertical type tool. So if we click on the standard, you will now see a red outline appear around the text in the program panel. Now you can just click on the text and type in your new text. I'll just type out Premiere Gal. You can then move on to update the font and the size. To update the font, you'll need to first select all the text using Command A and then choose another font. Then you can use the slider tool to increase and reduce the size. You can adjust the tracking, kerning, leading, and the baseline shift if you want to. You can also adjust the fill color of the text, and you can add a stroke. Now, the only downside here is that we have less customization with the stroke. In the old titler tool, you could choose from an inner or an outer stroke. You will notice that we do not have that option. You can also add a drop shadow, but right now it's hard to see. Unfortunately, you can't turn on the transparency here. You need to actually add a color mat behind the title layer in the sequence so you can see what the drop shadow looks like. So let's just go down to new item and create a quick little new light colored mat to lay underneath the motion graphs template in the timeline. Now let's go back up to the text in the Essential Graphics panel, and you can see that you can adjust the opacity, angle, distance, and the blur to the drop shadow. You will now see that we need to adjust the shape layers here. So we can go and select that layer, we can scale up the graphic, or if you don't want them, you can simply delete it by clicking on that layer and then hitting delete. Okay, so let's say if you wanted to make a new title from scratch, how do we do that? Simply select the text tool from the toolbar and then click in the black area of the program panel. This will start a new title. Now, let's just go ahead and make a lower third, and I'm gonna show you how to save it as a motion graphics template. So I'm just gonna type out Premiere Gal, and I'm going to change the font to a new typeface. And then over here in the align and transform area, you can adjust the position of where the text is. Or my favorite new feature is that you can go down and select the selection tool and then move the title in the program panel to whatever desired location that you want in the frame. Now let's say you want to insert a logo or a graphic. No problem. Simply click on the new layer icon here in the Essential Graphics panel, and it will ask you what type of new layer you want to make. You can choose from text, vertical text, rectangle, ellipses, and from a file. In this case, let's select from file, and I'm going to choose to import the GAL logo. Now, obviously, it's way too big right now, so let's just click on the layer and scale it down using the scale tool. If this lock icon is blue, it means it's turned on, and it will let you scale down the graphic proportionally. You can also scale it down proportionally by clicking and dragging a corner. You do not need to hold the shift key as the lock is turned on. Now let's add a rectangle behind the text. All you have to do is go up to New Layer and select Rectangle. A new rectangle will appear in the program panel. Now I'm going to make the fill white and change the size and location to be in line with the text and the new logo that I added. You can scale up the view of the program viewer by clicking on the dropdown next to Fit and changing the scale. So this is something we couldn't do in the Titler tool. So once you get it in the place that you like, you'll realize, wait a minute, how do I bring the text and logo in front of the rectangle? Well, the layers here in the Essential Graphics panel actually function like layers in Photoshop. So all you have to do is go over and drag the rectangle layer below the text in the logo layer, and then it will be behind. So then we can make further adjustments like changing the font color so it's easier to see, and make any other further adjustments you like. So let's say that you want to use the same style, the same lower third in future videos. Well, this is easy. All you have to do is save it as a motion graphics template. Just right click on the text in the timeline and select Export as a Motion Graphics Template. You can export it to your Essential Graphics panel, to your local drive, or even better, you can export it to the Creative Cloud Library, which you can share with other team members if you're on a team project file. So I'm just going to export it to the Essential Graphics panel, and then when you go back to the panel, you will see that now our lower third is there. You can also make new folders by clicking on the folder icon, and then you can right-click on the new template you made and move it to a new folder. Then you can choose this template as a starting point in your future videos. So that's it. I hope you guys found this useful, and if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. If you go to my Patreon page, you can get a free new Premiere Pro and video editing template each month when you donate $5 or more. I make new video production tutorials every week, so I will see you guys very soon. Bye!